in the next period of day after tomorrow. So the next article is significant things. Significant things. Let us see what is significant here. Let us suppose that a length of an object, length of a rod is measured. Length of a rod is measured by, suppose, vernier caliper, and it is equal to 1.23 centimeters. So it is measured using vernier caliper. Measured by vernier caliper. So what is the least count of vernier caliper? So it is known to you. You have performed the experiment in the laboratory. 0.01 centimeter. 0.01 centimeter. So let us suppose that the length of the rod is measured by vernier caliper and it is equal to 1.23 centimeters. So due to the least count 0.011, so in the measurement 1.23, what is going to change? 1 is not going to change. 1.2 will be fixed. If it is changed, so the value will be, if another person has measured, suppose, so there will be an error of 0.01 or 0.02, 0.1, 0.24, it may come 1.26, it may come 1.22. So what is changing? This number is changing. So the number 1 and 2 are not changing. Those numbers are fixed. So these two numbers are, which are not going to change, those are called reliable numbers. Reliable figures or reliable numbers. 1 and 2, in this, the number 1 and 2 are called reliable digits. Or in Marathi, we can say Vishwasaniya. And reliable digits. And what is going to change? Which digit is going to change? 3. So this is called first uncertain digit. Uncertain. So that is not certain, which is going to change. Uncertain digit. In Marathi, we can write as anischit. We cannot say that this is best. It may change. Is it? So first uncertain digit. So in any measurement, the total reliable digits and the first uncertain digit, they are togetherly called significant figures. Significant figures means the reliable digits and the first uncertain digit in the given measurement are called significant figures. So no doubt, the significant figures depend upon the least count of the measuring instrument. There are some rules of writing significant figures. Rules of significant figures. Rules. The first rule. All non-zero digits, which are not zero digits, are significant. That means, let us take an example, 2303, 2343, or 47.0, 47.34, or 93.8293. So all these are the non-zero digits. So suppose this is a number given to you. How many significant figures are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here are 4 significant figures. How many significant figures? Irrespective of decimal, if the number is non-zero digit, is a non-zero digit, then it is considered as a significant number or figure. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 significant figures in this number. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 centimeter figures in this way. So this is the first one. Second, so these rules are very important to find the answers of MCQ. All the zeros, number of zeros in two non-zero digits between two non-zero digits are significant. For an example, let us suppose 2.303 or 23.00909. So this is an example. Suppose. So how many significant figures are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 4 significant figures. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 significant. These 3 zeros are significant because they occur in 2 non-zero numbers. So this 0 is also significant because this occurs in two non-zero numbers. So all the zeros between 2 non-zero digits are significant. So they are considered to be significant. This is the second rule. The third. Let us suppose 0.00593. Suppose this is the measurement case. So these zeros are not significant. That means the third rule is if the given number is less than 1, this number is less than 1, then the number of zeros occurring to the right of decimal point and to the left of first non-zero, which is the first non-zero number after the decimal point. This is the first non-zero. So between decimal point and the first non-zero number, so these zeros are not significant. The number of zeros which occur between the decimal point and the first non-zero number are not significant. So how many significant figures are there? Here only significant figures are 3 and not 5. These are the 3 significant figures. These zeros are not significant. Okay. The fourth rule. Do you know the word trailing zeros? Trailing means ending zeros, which occur at the end. Trailing means occur at the end. Ending zeros, trailing zeros in a number, you please listen carefully. Trailing zeros in a number without decimal point are not significant. This is the fourth A rule, supposed to. For an example, 4700. These two zeros are not significant because they are coming at the end. So these two zeros are the trailing zeros or ending zeros. These two are not significant in a number which is without decimal point. So here the decimal point comes? No. So a number without decimal point, in that number, the zeros which are coming at the end, they are not significant. On the other hand, there is a sub rule or main rule, which may be
is an important rule. If a measurement is taken, suppose a length of an object is taken and it is equal to 3700 meters. So in a measurement, even though the number is without decimal point and there are trailing zeros, the ending zeros which are coming at the end of the figure of number, there are four significant figures. How many figures are there? Four significant figures. So here the two zeros are considered even though there is no decimal point. The rule is trailing zeros or ending zeros at the without decimal point are not significant. But in a usual number, if it is a measurement, then these two zeros are considered. Therefore, there are four significant numbers. Or you may be confused. Here it is suppose 23700 meters, something is the measurement. So there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 significant figures, isn't it? So this way we noticed. You should note this point. So this is about the fourth rule, the fifth rule. The trailing zeros in a number with decimal point are always significant. Always significant. For an example, 37.00. These zeros are considered, they are significant. Therefore, how many significant figures are there? Significant figures 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures. SF, significant figures, how many? 4 figures. Or 2.03400. So, how many significant figures are there? 1, 2, 3, this is considered. These are pertaining to the 2 non zero numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 significant figures. So these two zeros which occur at the end in the number having decimal point are considered are significant, isn't it? So this is about the fifth rule. The seventh rule. Next one. Seventh. The power of 10 in a number, in a quantity or in number, tens are not significant, are not considered to be significant. That means, suppose there is a number you want to do, 2.1 into 10 raised to 7. This is the number you want to do. So, how many significant figures are there? Only 2 significant figures. These zeros are not considered. Not significant. These zeros are not significant. The 8th one, last one. The significant figures does not change with the choice of system. With the choice of system of units. That means they does not change. If the measurement is given to you, if a measurement is 2 point or 20 meters is a length of an object, suppose 20 meters. So how many significant figures are there? 2 significant figures. If we convert the meter into centimeter, if you convert the length into CGS system or centimeter, so how many centimeters will be there? 101 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So even though there are only 2 significant figures, because these 2 zero are come from the conversion factor, so this is not the fashion of writing length when it is converted in the centimeter figures. You should write it 20 into 10 raised to 2 centimeters. So this is the conversion factor, and it should not be considered in the not significant. Should not be considered in the significant figure. So how many? So even though we change the system, SI system into CGS system, the significant figures remain the same. Single figure does not change. Isn't it? So this is about the significant figures. So the last point is to be noted carefully. Okay?